Card is coming. Let's see if the jack comes. It doesn't.
Feldman fills up on the river. Makes a check. Oh my gosh, and he slides it in. What in the heck just happened?
Wait, what did C said? He shoved his chips in and Ryan
Armenian calls. Mike moves all in, and Feldman makes a snap call. And Armenian tries to take his rack back.
You guys follow me on my Twitter or on my Instagram. You might have seen the clip that I posted this weekend of an incident that took place on Live at the Bike last Friday night between Ryan Feldman and Armenian Mike. And what went down was debatably one of the worst angles me and many other people out there have ever seen take place in poker, and overall an incredibly weird and unique situation. Now, I was trying to figure out how I should make this video, and I just didn't see a way to do it without playing the hand out in its entirety. So the hand's about 7.5 minutes. So if you go skip ahead from here, about 7.5 minutes, I'll talk more at the end about what I thought about what took place, about the floor man, about with Ryan, about with Armenian Mike, what Garrett said, and I'll go over some of the comments and the many interesting things that people out there have said. So if you want to go ahead 7.5 minutes from now, if you've already seen the hand, but if not, check it out.
Turn is a 10.
So now Garrett picks up a pair, Key has a pair. Ryan's going to bet out with his two pair. Interested in coming along.
You fucked up.
Okay, thanks.
But he says, if my card comes, you fucked up. Card is coming. Let's see if the jack comes. It doesn't.
Feldman fills up on the river. Makes a check. Oh my gosh, and he slides it in. What in the heck just happened?
Wait, what did C said? He shoved his chips in and Ryan
Armenian
calls.
Mike moves all in, and Feldman makes a snap call. And Armenian tries to take his rack back.
He's saying that he doesn't put his chips in?
Now he's saying that he's joking and that he doesn't have anything.
To me, that's an all-in in a call. Hold on, listen to what he's saying.
He's saying, let's go mute here.
What do you want me to do, Mike?
Thank you,
Gene. I didn't
bet, Mike. I checked.
Yeah, but I'm checking too for that bullshit. I say all in.
Why didn't you say check?
Either I don't put my hands down. Just I'm doing this all the time with you.
I don't know. You guys can decide what to do. I mean, obviously the floor is over. Mike, why would you say all in if you're kidding?
Come on, man. Don't do this bullshit. Fuck the chips. But
I didn't.
You know I'm doing joke with you all the time.
I didn't know that. I have the nuts.
Four checks.
Yes, second bet.
6-7, I think she's got right in the middle. She calls.
I mean, he's kidding, but I mean, what am I supposed to do?
My fucking check the camera. This money, it's here or not? I drop it.
So,
Mike, I don't want to take your money legitimately, but I mean, what do you want me to do?
Push it forward.
I mean, you could have a flush or a king. Like, what do you want?
I don't have no flush, no king. I just tell him the joke. You want to show him? Look at it.
No, okay.
Look at it. I'm doing bullshit with you.
I mean, why would you do that?
I'm doing bullshit to you. You see it.
I want to. I am going to officially go on record here and say that my opinion is that Armenian Mike should be all in. He should definitely lose his $10,000. He did the same thing with Jack 3 earlier. He did the same thing multiple times, and everyone folded. Now that he's gotten caught, he definitely needs to lose his money.
What am I supposed to do here?
You should get a ruling.
Should I let him keep it or what? I don't
you should get a ruling.
Garrett, you tell me what I'm supposed to do here.
I think the rule was that.
No, I don't want to. I want to know what. Garrett, what am I supposed to do here?
Okay, I don't even know what's really going on. Mike, you know I really like you, but for sure, like, I was just going to let it play out, but for sure, you have to give him that. For sure, you bet. You can't, like, in the middle of a hand, bet and then say it's a joke.
Can I ask a question? I put the money like
since
this,
I wasn't in the hand, I don't want to say anything else.
Yeah, but
you guys
money
can figure it out,
like
but
this.
It's like.
Okay, just tell me something. I'm doing this kind of joke with you or not?
I did not interpret the joke. That's why I called.
It's not a joke at all.
But Mike, what if Art has called you on the other hand when you had Jack 3, would you say it's a joke?
It was not a joke at all.
You did the same thing to Art and he folded.
Okay.
No, I'm just saying. I don't want to take your money, but like,
right, it's
what?
You want to take it?
I don't want to take
money, but you know I'm doing the joke all the time with you.
You could have folded your hand.
I didn't know it was a joke, Mike. You could have a flush.
Listen. Still, you are doing this bullshit. I show you my card.
I checked. I didn't bet.
I do this like this and the money in my hands.
take the chips.
You have to take the chips.
I don't, like...
You went all in, you called.
But, like, okay. when Art had pocket eights, he folded for you, and you bluffed him for 7K.
Yeah.
Like, what is he supposed to do? If you shove 7K and Art calls, you can't take it back?
Can I ask one more question?
Yeah.
You want this money?
I don't know, Mike.
But I'm telling you, I'm doing the job with you. You want this money?
I mean, I called.
And go fuck the money.
I called because I had the nuts and you bluffed into me. Like,
I'm going to bluff. I dropped this fucking money.
You want to make a ruling? Or you going to make a ruling?
No, of course I have to make a ruling.
The ruling is okay. Well,
yeah, yeah. Can I say something?
Based on what you guys telling me, right?
I don't know what you are talking about, sir. I'm talking with him. It's your fucking hand.
This seems like a spot where the floor man needs to come in and make a strong ruling on what he thinks is right.
Okay.
So unfortunately, I think the floor man is there right now, right?
Yeah.
Is he saying?
What do you want to do?
Is he talking to the floor?
I don't care.
See, and this is a particularly uncomfortable spot for Ryan because
Mike, I don't want you to be upset with
Ryan is
he's the producer of the show.
Yeah, like he you know, he has a relationship with a lot of these players. He creates these games. So it's just a delicate situation for him, and I think that the floor needs to step in and make what look at the camera and say this is not have this is a floor decision.
Guys, I think just to be done with this, I think Mike is right. In the end, the floor's made a ruling that it's a bet, so it's up to Ryan. He either wants to follow the floor's ruling or not. So just decide that, and then we'll move on.
This is such an absolutely brutal spot for Ryan here.
I'm okay.
The floor should not allow this. The floor should step in and say he has to pay him the money. Don't put this on Ryan.
And then we can move on with the other hands.
I feel like that's putting the pressure on Ryan. Like, he's literally putting the spot, you know what I mean? Like,
all right, fine. I mean, I don't know what else I can do. I already said, like, I clearly think it's a bet. I've already said the floor thinks it's a bet.
I think it's very unfair to put this on Ryan here.
If Art had called correctly, would you tell him you're kidding?
You guys want to discuss this on a side?
But you can't do that. There's four people in the hand.
Okay, now.
You can't go all in against four people and then say, I'm kidding. He did the same thing five times already. Like, what if, like, Art, if you had called, would you give him the money back?
If he didn't have a full house, he wouldn't have called.
So what am I supposed to do? The only reason is you've done that every time.
Him, I'm telling one more fucking time. I don't want to talk no more. You taking my joke or not? Tell me yes or no.
Mike, I don't know, man. I don't know what you want me to do. Like, you bluffed against Art.
Watch the money, man.
Yeah, this is a particularly tough spot. Tougher than it may appear, given the relationship that Ryan has with Mike.
Armenian Mike needs to man up here and pay. Not ask him if he should pay. He needs to pay.
Yeah, I mean... But the ruling's already been made, and like I don't even know what there is to talk about. Like he has to give him the chips. Like he made a bet, you know, he bluffed and got caught. There's nothing really to talk about.
Yeah, I think that Garrett's spot on there with that.
Like,
I agree with
one
Garrett.
Thing to you? Ryan is just such a nice guy that he's not. No, you're fine. You're fine too. That like I think he's like he's unwilling to like accept like the ruling that's clearly fair. It's just fair that he gets the chips, Mike. I think you know you made it.
That's really great of Garrett
like,
to say that.
I'm glad that Garrett is saying
because
something
it's
right
taking
now.
Some of the onus off Ryan, which is clearly you know devastating
decision,
him right now.
Because I just called. I don't want to make a decision because you because what if I got bluffed
for,
and have to fold? Like,
I'm gonna recap
so
what happened.
Sounds like he's leaving it there with Ryan.
Mike, that's good of you to do the right thing. Thank you.
So now you guys can see what happens here. Feldman makes a full house on the river. He decides to check over to Armenian Mike. Armenian Mike shoves in $10,000 into a $900 pot. Ryan instantly calls, and then Mike pulls his chips back, talks about how he's joking around, like he's a comedian, talking about, I'm telling you a joke, I'm joking with you, and trying to get the money back from Ryan. Then at some point in time, the floor man comes over, and now usually a floor man is going to make a ruling, is going to say this is how it goes, but the floor man here decides to say, Ryan, it's up to you. You make the decision. Now Ryan sits there, hand in his head, not sure what to do, asks Garrett a couple times what he should do. Garrett decides to speak up. He says, you know, you made this bet, Mike. You got to pay him the chips. And then once again, sort of says that again at the end. And then eventually Mike ends up giving Feldman the 10K, storms off after a big scene takes place. And now what went down here? What the hell just happened, right? What's going on? Why did it turn out like this? Is this the kind of shit that happens on Live at the Bike regularly? First of all, no, that's not what this kind of stuff that happens on Live at the Bike regularly. But this is a very, very unique situation that I want to talk more about the dynamic of the relationships between these three players. So Feldman is the co-owner, the producer, and the host of the show. He organizes the lineups. He knows a lot of these players. He's known a lot of players for quite a long time. Mike is a longtime player on Live at the Bike. From what I've seen him play, a recreational poker player, I don't think he's making a living or winning money in these games. And a longtime player on the show. They obviously have a relationship with the floor man here. Feldman pretty much at the bike almost every single day putting these shows on. I've seen him interact with the floor guys. He knows a lot of the floor guys. I think they, you know, they's kind of thought of as Ryan's in charge of the show. And if something happens, then Ryan potentially can make a ruling or decide what might go down in some situations. So now, why didn't the floor just come over and say, all right, that's a bet, pay him the money? I mean, to me, I watch his hand. You slide your chips across the middle into the pot. There's no, I'm joking, okay? There's no joke. This isn't how poker works, okay? Now, I'm trying to figure out where Mike could be coming from with the joke. And now, to me, he'd been playing pretty aggressive and very weird in the session. He made a $10,000 bet into a $350 pot earlier in the session. He three bet, I think like a jack three or something like that. It went four way to a flop. The flop's 5-5-2. He shoved all in with the jack three. I don't know if this is how it usually plays. I'm not studying his game. I don't really know what exactly his usual play style is, but I'm told he's a nit. And it looks like he just lost his mind a little bit this session. So now the hand in question comes up. And now to me, what it looks like is that Mike is leveraging his friendship with Ryan. Ryan being a nice guy, he's leveraging that niceness of Ryan. He's trying to take advantage of Ryan from my standpoint and not have to pay him the money. And I think that without Garrett speaking up, I don't think Feldman would really have taken the money. And now people say, should the producer of the show or the host of the show be playing in the game? And now I know a lot of private games, and most of those games, the host plays in the game. If they don't play in the game, they can't afford to play in the game, or they can't sell enough action to play in the game, or they're just not simply good enough to play in the game and they keep losing a lot of money. But it's not unusual for a host of the show to be playing in the games that they put together. Now, you could say it's televised, that maybe you shouldn't play in there. And now I can see merit for both sides of the situation, but I don't personally see anything that out of line about Ryan deciding to play in these games. He's been playing in the games for a long time. Not often at the 2550 and beyond stakes. Maybe once or twice I've seen him play, but maybe it should be at certain stakes, maybe not. I don't think that's really, I mean, maybe some people do have a big issue with that. I personally don't. Now, the floor man in this spot, obviously I think the floor man should come over and make a ruling, and it's a very obvious and straightforward ruling. But I can understand him wanting to defer to Ryan. A lot of people have been saying the floor man should be fired, he should be banned, I don't really know. They're saying some crazy shit about the floor man. But I can kind of see where the floor man's coming from. With that said, I think he probably looks back on this in retrospect and says, yeah, I should have just made a ruling. But, you know, with how the way Ryan was acting, you know, maybe he didn't feel comfortable. I don't really know exactly the specifics on why the floor man didn't just come over and make a ruling, strong stance on something one way or the other. But hopefully we'll be able to find out that in the future. And now a lot of people have been commenting on Ryan, the way Ryan handled the situation. And I think Ryan handled the situation, not like I would have handled it, but I think Ryan's much different personality than I am. I don't think he really wants to make anybody angry. He doesn't want to make anybody upset. He doesn't want to make anybody feel like he's taking money from them when he shouldn't be taking money from them. But this is just a very straightforward spot of you made the bet. It's a dumb bet. It's an idiotic bet that you've made earlier in the session. You lost the hand. Just give the guy the fucking money. You lost the hand. It's over. You don't need to go back and forth complaining about it's a joke. It's a joke. It's a joke. I mean, I'm trying to think how he could be joking, but I can see where it could be coming from with the joke. Maybe he thought it was funny. He's going to go all in. He shows the bluff. Ha ha. And then when he gets called, he's like, oh shit, I didn't expect that to happen. Like, let me carry this on for a while. I don't know, man. I really don't know. It just seems like he's trying to take advantage of Ryan, take advantage of his place as a recreational poker player, take advantage of the potential friendship that he has with Ryan, and not pay this guy the money that he owes when he knows he made a dumb play and he made a mistake. So do I think Mike was out of line? Of course, he's out of line after the hand. Just give the guy the money. Let's move on to the next hand. GG, come back next week. Let's try again. There's no need for that to happen. The floor man, was the floor man out of line? I think he would even say, yes, he should have just come over. He made a ruling. Is this the worst floor man ever? I don't think we know enough information about the floor man to say this is the worst guy ever. He needs to be fired. I don't think so. I'm sure the guy puts in the hard work. If he was sucked at a job, he'd be fired already. Do people make mistakes? Yes, they make mistakes. Do we need to be harsh on this floor man? I don't think so. I think he knows, all right, let's do better in the future. Do we need to look at Mike as the worst person of all time? I don't think so as well, too. Could he have been coming from a place of non-malicious intent? I think so. I could potentially see how he might have thought it was a joke to him, and he really believed that this was a joke and that things were getting carried away. And maybe for a second, you know, he's trying to get the money back, also merged with some sort of joke. I can kind of see where he's coming from. But come on, man, it's ridiculous. It's ridiculous that this incident took place. The incident blew up this big. And I found it extremely fascinating, the feedback and the amount of anger and hostility sent towards Mike's way. Big applause to Garrett for actually stepping up and for saying things. And now some people at the table said, well, the rest of the guys at the table are scared or this or that. And I don't know, man. I don't think that people would be so fast to necessarily speak up, because I've heard in the, like, sometimes people speak up in the past and they say, oh my God, butt out of it, stay out of it. It's not your fucking money. I've heard this so many times of people getting upset, other people for standing up for other players in the table and saying, you're not involved in the pot, shut the fuck up. I've heard those exact words more than one time. So I can understand people not willing to speak up. And now Garrett has a certain reputation. He's known as the wild man. He's known as the high stakes player. He's known as the guy who has these massive swings. So I think he gets a lot of respect from both Ryan and from both Mike, where to the point where he can actually stand up and say something here. And I did hear throughout the clip where someone else maybe tried saying something and then Mike got a little combative with that person. So I can understand someone not wanting to get combative with Mike. He seems like a gregarious guy, in your face kind of guy. Other guys in the game, maybe just quiet people. I don't see any harm on those people in the game to the point where they need to stand up and say something. I'd like to think in the moment I would say something, but at the same time, maybe I wouldn't. Maybe I don't want to be in that confrontation. Maybe I'm losing for the day. So I think it's a very unique thing that never really happens. So I can't fault other players for not stepping up or standing up and really saying something. So Garrett did decide to do that. And like I said, without Garrett standing up for Ryan, I don't know if it really would have got paid. So now I got a ton of feedback on Twitter and on Instagram for posting this clip. A couple of the feedback of the tweets that I have from Sean McCormick, who is the boss of the Aria Poker Room. He said, my three takeaways from this video. 1, floor man, make a ruling. You're the only impartial party. 2, Mike, please take off the Aria hat. 3, Mike, if you're ever in Vegas, your action is not welcome at the Aria Poker. He says, if we take harder stances on angles, they will be less likely to happen. And I completely agree with that. I think that this clip going so viral, I think that a video like this is a deterrent for people to angle in the future. It's a way for people to be educated that these type of angles are taking place on maybe a regular basis in some games that you play. And also, it's a lesson on how to handle yourself if you do end up in a situation like this. Now, do I agree with that Mike should be not welcome at the Aria? Well, that's Sean's decision to make, and I completely understand where Sean's coming from. He probably doesn't want his players to get taken advantage of at his casino. So, and he doesn't want a player like Mike there, and he's got more than enough players to make up the action for that. So I applaud Sean for taking a stance like that and for actually speaking out on this situation. And I think, I think a lot of the poker world really appreciated that and respected his decision. This one here is from William Walsh. Sir, the action is on you. Do you check, bet, or joke? I mean, yeah, that's probably going to be the new thing. When you make a bet on the river, you're just joking about it. Garrett Adelstein, who's involved in the hand, said, this situation is unfortunately similar to many others I've had to deal with in live poker, often for a lot more money, often with zero backup from other players, just trying to protect their interest. Stay thirsty, my friends. See you next Friday, Mike. Dan Fleischman on Twitter. Video lasted 7.5 minutes longer than it needed to. Mike didn't even have his hand on the chips. He slid the rack in, then flicked it in farther, even while announcing all in. The floor shouldn't have even needed to walk over for a ruling because there was no option for joke. I completely agree with that. I don't even know why the floor came over. It's a straightforward case, like I said earlier. Bet, give him the money, that's it. So I had a couple back and forths here with Pat Cruz. He said, yes, it's obvious to me why it went on for so long. Mike is a fish. No one wants to upset the fish. The floor is atrocious. Everyone involved in the game other than Garrett is spineless and was silent out of selfishness. Kim Lim said, this isn't even an angle. This is just him straight up trying to cheat Ryan. If Ryan folded a pair here, would Mike say, just kidding, I have ace high, you win? Nah, of course not. So he got caught bluffing and now wants to play up their friendship. They should ban him. Yeah, once again, I do see where Kim's coming from here. Would Mike have said he's just joking, you take the money? I don't think so. I think if he makes the bet and Ryan folds, he's not going to give him the money back. So he's not going to say Ryan wins the pot. So Dallyman on Twitter said, Garrett did some A-plus game preservation here. from all angles just goes to show that there's so much more to poker than being good at cards. Shit that might come up once or twice in your poker career like this can have a gigantic effect on your bottom line. So now, where do we go from here? What should happen next? What are our big takeaways? What can we learn from the situation? Should Mike be able to be played on Live at the Bike again? And now, I wrote down, I'm not going to play with this guy again, but I saw some of the plays he made this session. I want to play with a guy like this. I want to play with a guy making these bad plays. I don't know if these are regular plays he makes, but it's kind of how things work sometimes in these games, these higher stakes games. Is that the recreational poker player that's a losing player, that they're allowed to do weird things and then come back in the future. Is that right? Is that wrong? I'm not the one to say, is that right or wrong? Would it be in a perfect world? Is everybody in line and not making plays like this and not trying to take advantage of other people's kindness or take advantage of their spot as a fun player? In a perfect world, that wouldn't exist. But this is the poker world, far from a perfect world, and things like that are always going to take place. Should Mike be allowed to play on Live at the Bike again? I don't know. I don't think so. I wouldn't want to have him back if I'm putting on the show. I wouldn't want an incident like that again to take place. I would prefer to have people in the game that aren't going to make a big stink and get themselves into situations like that. I feel like the biggest takeaway for me is that how can we avoid spots like that if we're in it? Now, I think we do need to, if we get into a spot, we need to stand up for ourselves. We need to say, listen, this isn't going to happen. A lot of people are shy out there, or they're nice guys, or they're like Ryan, and it's just like, it seems like a lose-lose spot. If you take the money, you're gonna alienate this player that you're friends with, that you've known for a long time. Over what? Over $10,000? Is it that big of a deal to you in the grand scheme of things to ruin something like that, or to make an enemy out of $10,000 in your mind? Now, I think that's one way to look at it, but I think the other way to look at it is that this is how the game works. If you made this play, you'd have to pay the money. Someone does it to you and they don't want to pay you. What kind of friend are they really? What kind of friendship is this? If I have a friend and I play poker against them and they make a bet like that and I call them and they did the same thing earlier, but then they say, it's a joke, I'm joking with you, I'm not going to pay you. I just don't want to be friends with that guy. Like, don't play with me anymore, dude. If it's that important to you to just, this is how you operate, this is the way that you joke, it just doesn't make any sense, man, okay? So to me, I don't want to be friends with that guy. I don't consider that guy a friend to me. I think it's just, you got to stand up for yourself, guys. You don't let this kind of shit happen to you. You got to say, pay me my money, man. Like, it might end up weird. It might end up in a situation. But to me, that's how I would handle it. I just say, listen, if this is going to ruin our friendship, this is going to ruin the relationship we have, then it ruins the relationship that we have. So also something to note is that this is kind of something I reached out and I talked to Barry about, Barry Greenstein. And he said, anytime a weird bet like that takes place in a game I'm in, I always don't snap call. I don't insta call. I try to make sure that actually took place. Because with these guys, weird things do happen. And he kind of explained some situations that's happened in the past to him. You know, very equivalent. They're in the same ballpark. Not obviously the same situation. But he made a lot of sense to me. And I think that is a big takeaway, is that when something unusual happens, just take a couple seconds. Don't insta-call. Verify that the person made that bet. Verify the action that took place. And then make your decision from there. So hopefully people out there aren't going to be taken advantage of by these angles. But I think the most important thing is that you just be alert. You know, there's any time you play, there could be some double A taking place. There could be some people hiding chips, some people trying to all sorts of different things. I don't really know all the angles. I don't have the live pro angles down quite yet at this point in time in my life. And I'm sure that I might get taken advantage of once or twice. And I try to learn from those things. And I certainly am going to learn from this incident that took place, of just make sure the bets are verified and make sure that the floor is actually going to come over and make a ruling and then sticks by that ruling. Because ultimately, with the floor decision, I mean, that's ridiculous. That should never have taken place. And now there's a ton of different comments out there. I'll link to my main tweet and my main Instagram post, and you guys can go read the comments if you're interested in what everyone else has to say. Also, people are going to comment on this video and let us know what you think. And I'm going to enjoy reading it. I'm really enjoying kind of getting the feedback from people out there and seeing what their thoughts are on the situation. And yeah, where do we go from here? I don't know, man. I hope we don't have something like this happen again in the future. But I suspect we'll see another angling incident happen before sooner than later. So yeah, guys, let me know what you thought about the video. Let me know what you thought about the incident. And peace out. Adios. Take care. Much love.